Chris Mailer for BBTV. We're over at Salford Boxing Academy here in Earlham. I'm very pleased to say I'm joined by Yui Fury. Yui, it's great to see you there.
Yeah, good to be back in training and stuff, so ready to go again.
Yeah, sparring night tonight.
Good few rounds, different lads in and out, and that's it, you're preparing for the 12th of July.
Yeah, you've had a one in, one out, so all different types of styles, it's all good.
Yeah, it's all good.
Keep you on point.
Exactly, it's good, you've got different styles, all explosive, fresh, and you just got to deal with the pressure.
You said there, July the 12th, there's been an announcement that you're going to be fighting Samuel Peter over there in Saudi Arabia. It's a bit of a turn up. I mean, you was in the Victoria Warehouse not long ago, and there you find yourself.
I know. Like I say, I'm not afraid to travel all around the world, so that's the fight with something next, and I'm looking forward to it.
What did you think about the name Samuel Peter when it was put to your former world champion? And you know, I'm sure his best days are behind him, but he was some punching in his day. Do you know much about?
Yeah, listen. They always say punching never loses your touch, so the father can still punch. And I'm looking forward to the fight. So it's going to be a good night. And when he said that Samuel Peter, I said, yeah, good name, and look forward to the fight. It doesn't bother me who they put in front of me. So it was a fight. It's a fight.
Was there a shortlist, or was that the name that was put to you straight away?
I think he's trying to struggle getting fights, so I think that's what the fighter was willing to take it, so that's what we end up with.
And it looks like, you know, after the Pulev fight, you had the cut, you recovered from that. Hearing your dad speak in the past, he now just wants to keep you busy, and that's the plan that he's come up with.
Yeah, keep him busy and get me out there as much as possible. So far, it's looking like he's going ahead.
How is the cut?
Yeah, cut's good.
Healed really well.
Yeah, healed really well, and just looking forward to now is getting these fights out of the way. So where that's holding me back a bit, so now I can just go full force.
I mean, you said you're going to keep busy, and you just said there, get these fights out of the way. What are you looking at doing? And obviously, you're going over to Saudi Arabia, that's the next thing, and you're not going to overlook that. But are you just looking to stay busy and then eventually work towards a world title shot?
Whatever fight comes up, whatever fight after this, if the big fights come, I'll take them, I'm ready. So whoever comes and whoever's next, we'll just look one fight at a time.
Willing
to fight anyone.
If the opportunity comes your way.
If the opportunity comes away, we take it.
What about when you look on the domestic scene? I mean, you was British champion, you relinquished that belt. There's some sort of fighter, well, David Price is fighting for it now against Dave Rhino. Do you ever think about sort of maybe going to the European domestic level or something?
I've got no interest in the British. I just want to get these out, all the bad curves are out the way, and now it's just focused full stream ahead of being at top level.
When you look back on the two setbacks, the one with Park and the one with Pulev, I mean, you are only 24. Do you still look on it as it's been like a learning curve for you? You've learned your trade.
Yeah, you've got to take them as learning curves and benefit from them and just move forward. And you can't really dwell on them. So, like I say to you, you just take them as the past and you move forward. Help you keep busy and get back to the top.
So on Saudi Arabia, what do you think about fighting over there?
Yeah, I've never been over there, so it's going to be a great experience.
You've been a bit of a road warrior, haven't you? You've fought all over.
Yeah, we've definitely fought over the show, but like you say, it's another one to add to the box.
Do you feel Peter poses a threat to you? How do you sort of see the fight going, and what are you looking to get out of this fight?
Like you say, we're just in there. What we're working in the gym with my dad, we just put that into practice, and that's it. And it's just another learning to get our skills off in the ring.
What do you feel are the main things you've learned over the last few years about yourself as a boxer, and what is it you're trying to improve on as you go forward?
Listen, you learn things every day in boxing, especially in the mental side, in the physical and determination, and it's the willpower to continue or not continue. Boxing pushes your levels to a different degree, but we've learned a lot, and now it's just putting all that learning and all them learning curves we've had into practice.
And you still believe that one day you'll get 100% shot and you will be a world champion?
Definitely, there's not a doubt in my mind. I won't put myself through agony every single day. I would have given up a long time ago if I thought that was the case.
It's an hard game.
It's an hard game, but you've got to keep on the hard work in, and you'll get there eventually.
Well, respect to you for that, and I wish you all the best, you week. good luck on the 12th of July.
Thank you very much, sir. Appreciate it.